AI-generated images are everywhere, even in e-learning. You may have used some in your own courses that you've created, or maybe you're new to AI and looking to get started. Freepik Pikaso is a great tool to use whether you are seasoned in AI or brand new, because it is beginner-friendly and it's also free to get started. Hello, I'm Sabrina, and my first video on the channel was introducing you all to Midjourney. If you're unfamiliar with Midjourney, check out that video, but essentially Midjourney is a tool that takes text and creates unique artworks and images that you can download. When I was doing the research for that video, I was a little overwhelmed because Midjourney has so many tools and features that you can use with it, and I would have loved a tool like Freepik Pikaso, Freepik's AI tool, to practice and play around with it. One, because it's beginner friendly. Two, it's free to get started. And three, it has some cool features beyond just text to image that we're going to explore today. Before we dive in any deeper, I do want to give a little disclaimer. The free version of Freepik is limited, just like any other tool's free version. It's going to have its limitations. So you can generate up to 20 images per day using Freepik's free tool. And some of the tools are locked, but you get access to quite a lot of features still. And then you can unlock everything under Freepik's paid subscription. And that subscription isn't just for the AI tool. It's for Freepik's full like asset library, their icon library, and then the AI tools as well. And you also get access to the beta versions of things before they come out. So the paid subscription is worth it. But if you're just diving in and just dabbling in AI generated images, the free version is going to be just perfect for you. Although that free version is limited, you can make the most of it if you go in with a strategic plan. So let's talk about how we can be strategic as we go through our Freepik free version. So one of the first things you're going to want to do is the same thing you would do with any tool, get familiar with the user interface. And we'll do that in this video. We'll take a look at the user interface, see what you have access to. The nice thing is you can just create your free account on Freepik, but you don't have to worry about like you can only log on to it so many times a day and see so many things. You can check things out. It's just how many times you generate images. That's what's limited. But you can go through and explore all of the user interface. So get familiar, make sure you know where things are, understand what each of the things do so you're not wasting any of your generated images. The next thing you can do is use ChatGPT to help you with prompt writing. I'm going to show a quick example here. So right here, we have my prompt was, I asked ChatGPT, can you help me write a prompt to describe an image? This is what I have so far, a dog playing with the ball. When I put that into Freepik, a dog playing with the ball, this is what we get. Okay, it's a dog playing with the ball. ChatGPT, of course, added a lot more details like this. The dog's eyes sparkle with anticipation and mischief, much more creative with the words. So I took that prompt, I put it into Freepik, and this is what we get. So we can see it's much more specific. They are playing with a tennis ball, which ChatGPT asked it to do. It asked to like highlight the dog's fur with the sunlight. It gave much more descriptors. Lush green meadow. We can see there is a lush green meadow. So it was much more descriptive than a dog playing with the ball. These pictures, like after looking at them with the sun shining here, feel kind of dull. So using ChatGPT to help you create a better prompt is a great way to go. The next way that you can be strategic is using permutation in prompts. So in Freepik's tool, you can use permutations like this here. So you'll see parentheses and vertical lines. What that does is it's telling the AI, here are some options. Use whatever you like, whatever combination you're choosing, and create some images. So from just this like simple prompt, we're giving it three colors of cats and two locations. We can generate up to six different images. And the AI is going to do what it will with this information. So here you can see these cats. We have an orange, black, white cat. Some are indoors and some are out in a sunny garden. I will say this isn't always accurate. That's just AI right now, currently. It's not always completely accurate. So something that I've noticed as I was practicing with this tool is when I would put like something like this, it would maybe give me a black and white cat and then an orange something in the background. So it was kind of mixing these things together. That's on the free version. On the paid version, it was a little bit more accurate with these permutations, but it is a way to generate multiple variations of an image with only one like round of generations. So that is one way to be very strategic as you work on these. The next thing and the last thing is to check out Freepik's blog on AI. They have lots of tips. So that is where this permutation blog came from. But it's just on Freepik's website where they have all of their different AI tools and tips. So that is a great thing to check out and see what tips they have to help you writing prompts and generate images with their free trial. With a strategic plan in mind, let's go ahead and head over to Freepik and start generating some images. All right, here we are in Freepik. To get here, you're going to go to freepik.com/Pikaso. And Pikaso is spelled P-I-K-A-S-O. If you're familiar with Freepik, getting graphics and assets from there, at the top, there's a spot where it says tools and you can access their AI tools there as well. But when you land on Freepik Pikaso, this is what you're going to see. Here are their tools that they have. The first one is the AI image generator. That's the one you're probably most familiar with where you write a text prompt and you get out an image. The next one is Reimagine. I think this is really cool and really beneficial because what you can do is take an image that you already have, bring it into the Reimagine tool, and you can change the style to whatever you need it to be, which is very beneficial. I don't know how many times it's happened to you, but it happens to me a lot where I find an image that I really love, but it's not necessarily the same style as everything else that I've already collected. And so having a tool where I can reimagine that image to match the style is exactly what I need and what I've been looking for. The next tool is a little bit more novel. That's Sketch to Image. And it's really cool. It may not be as accurate as you hope, but it's really cool. So what you can do is you give the AI a prompt, a text prompt, to kind of describe what you're drawing, and then you draw an image and it will create it on the other side. Really cool stuff. All of these have the option to download the image that you create, which is fantastic as well. All right, the next tool that's coming soon, it is available in the paid version, but it's not available to the free version just yet, is the Enhancer. What that's going to do is change the resolution of your image. So like go from 2K to 4K, things like that. So it just enhances your image. That's why it's called the Enhancer. The first thing we're going to check out is the AI image generator. Like I said, it's probably the one you're most familiar with, where you can put in a text prompt and go from there. So get rid of my old prompt. Let's go ahead and take a look at this bar up at the top. So this will take us back to the tools we just saw. Right here we have AI image generator. This is going to show you all of the tools. One thing I notice is when you click on the AI image generator from the menu, we don't see the AI image generator beta version. But when I went to the sketch version, I do see the beta version. So you may just have to refresh and kind of play around with it. And you can get access to the beta version on the free trial. Okay, I'll go back to the AI image generator. Right here is where we have our field to type in our prompt. Next, where we see this number 4, this is how many images we wanted to generate. Remember that you only get 20 images per day to generate. So you may want to only generate one picture at a time, or you may want to do 2 or 4, it's up to you. But remember, you only get 20 images to generate for this tool specifically. Each tool has their own limitations for the day. So for the AI image generator, text to image, you have 20 images to generate that day. Next is the ratio. So if you are creating a project in Storyline, you may be thinking already what ratio you're going to use. Most of the time we use 16:9, at least I do. So it's nice to know that I can go in and create an image that is already going to be the size I need. And then we have our create button. You can see your history and you can do some like new images. They do give you some like ideas of prompts to use. Yeah, that's it. So let's do something kind of basic. Let's do an astronaut on Mars with a dog. Not very descriptive. I should probably use ChatGPT to help me out. Let's only generate 2 images. Maybe I'm creating this for a mobile device e-learning experience. So I'll go 9:16 and let's create. So interesting choices. This first one here is actually really good. We have an astronaut with a dog, not really connected to the leash. This one, it kind of confused the prompt. We have two dogs who are making, it's kind of like the like kids stacked in a trench coat situation. We have two dogs in an astronaut suit. It did do a comic book style because when I was practicing before, I had it on comic book style. I can clear this out and regenerate. But up here we have the tools or styles, I guess. So you have all of these different styles. Anywhere where you see a crown, that is a paid option. So if you have the paid version, you'll unlock those. But there are quite a few different options that you do have access to. You can choose even the coloring. So if you're going for like a specific like feel, you can do that. Framing, again, if you really want to get all of these different pieces in here, really, really change things up, you can. So let's go to the style. Let's do cartoon. Let's choose our color. We're going to do split color. Just kind of having fun with it right now. For the framing, nah, we'll leave that. For the lighting, let's do golden hour. All right, I have all of my settings here, and now I'm just going to press create again. I'll keep it at two images, and let's see what happens. It went with the dogs stacked. That tells me I really need to work on this prompt a little bit better. So I should send it over to my friend ChatGPT, write a prompt, and then bring it back over here. But you get the idea. We're kind of getting this more cartoony Pixar kind of style, especially if we look at the hands. Oh, this one's actually kind of cute because he looks like he's in almost in like a baby Bjorn situation. You see his little paw sticking out. but now maybe this one has more of that like golden hour lighting that we were looking for. We said split color. It is doing that. We see blue, orange, darker purpley colors with some orange. And then it is in that cartoony Pixar kind of style. So it is doing what we asked it to do, mostly. I'm going to blame myself with the prompt and not so much the AI. All right, now if I decide that I do really like this one where the dog looks like he's in a baby Bjorn, I can select it. I can download it. I can use the prompt that the AI uses to describe this image and regenerate an image. We can take this image straight into that Reimagine tool and reimagine it into a different style. We can even bring it into that sketch tool and draw over it to add more features. So you have a lot of different options. You can also, if you're trying to come up with some different versions and you don't want to lose your past ones or search through your history, you can save it to your creations. And what that does, you saw it bring it down here, so we can come back and see it again. So some really cool features that we have here. All right, let's take a look at the next tool. Our next tool is going to be the Reimagine tool. So I went over to Freepik and found an image of an astronaut, but maybe I really wanted to still be in this like Pixar cartoony style. So over here, I'm going to select an image. So in my downloads, here is my little astronaut. And it's bringing it over. It's also going to write a prompt to describe it. And with the free version, you can adjust some pieces of the prompt. So I don't want this to be in a digital art style. It did already use some of my images. I have 4 uses left today, but you'll see it does generate a lot more pictures. So you kind of want to make sure you have all of these pieces set up. It does save from whatever you did the last time. So change it, I guess, before you get back into there. But here's our cartoon style. And you can change it from like subtle, vivid, or wild. Subtle is going to just change it just a bit. Vivid is going to be somewhere in between. And wild means you're giving AI like full range to just do whatever. So if we look, it's still keeping some of that cartoon style. That like comic book style. I'm not super sure why. Maybe because it's just in vivid. If we went wild, maybe it would do more. But if we look, this one is actually pretty good. It's giving that kind of more rounded Pixar kind of style. This one is definitely giving, these two here are definitely giving Pixar cartoon 3D style. So same thing, we can take this now and reimagine it again, or we can save it to our creations or take it and draw over this. Let's save it to our creations and let's go ahead and actually let's sketch over this. See if we can maybe add a planet or maybe add like a spaceship or something. So let's sketch over this image. The prompt it gave it is adorable style, adorable cartoon style. In this one, you have 90% or 100%, and it takes away percentages as you adjust things over here. So maybe I'm going to say, I'm going to add, or let's put an alien, or maybe UFO. UFO flying in the background. So I'm going to tell the AI kind of what I'm thinking. And then let's pick a color. Well, hopefully it doesn't make this like a sun or something. But let's try to draw a UFO back here. So you can see as I'm drawing, it's starting to like add it in. Maybe I want to give it more of like a... And then if I fill it in, oh, it kind of is making it look like an alien or some strange creature. Let's see, how can I... So as I was saying, it's kind of fun. It's not always super accurate. Maybe if I turn up the imagination, it'll be a little more imaginative and not directly what I'm drawing. So as I do adjust this, it will bring this down. So you can see as I was making adjustments to the image, my percentage was going down. Let's try. Okay, it's looking more satellite-like. Okay, more UFO style. Let's just go for it and go all the way imagination. We lost our UFO. And so that is what I was saying. It's like not super accurate. But it is going to try to take it and do whatever it can. It kind of seems like there was a sweet spot. It is going to warn you once you've used most of it. But that kind of seems like that's where the sweet spot was. If I want to save this image, I can download it here. And it's going to let me download the result. You can also download the composition so you can see like what your original was, especially if you drew lots of the pieces, and see what you actually created. So pretty cool stuff that you can see here. The other cool thing, if we go back, you can also watch the playback. So it's going to be just a video that shows you like as you're drawing. So if we were drawing a bunch of different things, it's going to show us how things changed until we got to the final image. So it's showing us all the variations and then goes to back to the start. So that's another cool feature. Not quite sure what you would use that one for other than showing like how you worked with the AI to generate an image. But yeah, some really cool stuff and some really cool features. The Freepik AI tool is really cool and has some really great features. It's also fantastic that it's beginner friendly. So if you are brand new to trying AI, it's a great tool to just start practicing with because it's free to start. There are a lot of AI tools out there, and having a tool like Freepik is fantastic because, again, it's pretty user-friendly. But if you're looking to explore a tool that's a little bit more powerful, check out the video that I did on Midjourney. We'll link it down in the description below. The images that we created today can be used in an e-learning project, and e-learning is just a small piece of instructional design. If you are just starting your instructional design journey, be sure to download the free Become an ID checklist that we will link down in the description below. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.